So students, today we're going to discuss letter writing. So keep your notebooks ready and please note down whatever is going to be discussed in the classroom. Okay, so a very important part of our writing skills that we will be doing this year throughout the year. One is your paragraph writing and second is your letter writing. Okay, so we have a letter to the editor and we have letter of complaint. Right, this term for the term one as per the CBSE guidelines, so that is what we are going to discuss. Right, so today we are going to discuss a letter of complaint. Now, as you all know, right, what do you think it suggests? It is complaining about any kind of product, it could be any kind of services, it could be, right? This letter of complaint, generally we write to the letter of the editor also, yes. We can write a letter of complaint as a business letter. A letter of complaint, it can be an official letter, right? Now, when we write a letter of complaint as a business letter, it could be that you ordered something, you placed an order for certain items, you placed an order for sports goods, or hosiery material or stationery item. And when you received the order, you found out that it was not up to the mark. Okay, right? Then naturally you are going to complain about it. You will correspond with them. You will tell them what the problem was, right? So these are what a letter of complaint generally deals with. It deals with addressing our problems, addressing our grievances that we have had. Now, when I talk about a business letter, what could it be about? It could be about the order that you had placed. Now, here, letter of complaint, you know, you can write a letter of complaint to the editor. When we write a letter of a complaint, yes, we have a complaint about so many things, about the condition of the roads, about the condition of the parks, right? How, right? Of course, nowadays we discuss that in this time of the pandemic, that how many people are there following this COVID protocol, right? So here it is, so the letter to the editor, it's a general complaint talking about the behavior of the public, okay, right? So it could be, yes, so like you talk about in the two-wheelers or the school buses, how the overcrowding happens, how people are not following the traffic rules, which is a cause of great concern. So when we write a letter of complaint to the editor, it is a complaint of a very general nature. It is not anyone in particular. We are discussing the public in general. Now they do not listen, they do not behave, and these are the problems, right? So there's a park in your colony, right? It is because people are not there, you know, like, of course, realizing that this park is an important part of the locality. You have to keep it clean, you have to keep it neat. You should not let unwanted elements come to disturb it, or come and sit over there and make the residents uncomfortable, right? So when we write a letter to the editor, it is a complaint of a general nature. When we write a letter of complaint as a business complaint, right? We have done business letters, you have done placing an order. Yes, have you done? And after, generally after we placed an order, we generally proceed on to writing a complaint. Now that complaint, when you talk about business letters, what could that complaint be? It could be about the order. What about the order? It was not satisfactory. Yes, right? So you're not happy with the quality of the goods. What other complaint can you do? What other complaint can it be? It could be the delay in sending of the goods, right? So like they had promised, say by 15th of July, and now it is soon going to be 25th, and even then you have not, right? So you are going to complain about that, right? So whether it is about the nature of the products received, whether it is about the delay in the receipt of the products, okay? Then it could be, yes, in a business letter, say you had hosted a function. So you had hosted a function and during the function, you noticed many problems. So whether it was about the quality of the food or whether it was about the behavior of the attendants, whether it was regarding cleanliness. So any of these issues you can complain about. Okay, right. So when you do talk about business letters, what is it going to be about? Yes, about the order that you placed. It got late. It is not up to the mark. If it is about any other services, right? So you hosted a function, you're not happy with the quality, right? So this is, the nature of the letter of complaints that we are going to write about. Is that clear? Yes. Now, when I come to official letters here, official, you're going to discuss a problem with a higher authority. So don't worry, we'll be discussing these letters, okay? I'm just telling here what are the various, letters of complaints that we can write. So when I talk about a complaint to the higher authorities, right? So that complaint, supposing you went to a shopping mall. And what did you notice? What did you notice? It could be, yes, the behavior of the attendants there or behavior of, the sales people, right? Yes, how they were not cooperating or they were not listening or they were rude. Or you, right nowadays, of course, we can always complain about that how social distancing or those protocols were not being followed. You could not find any sanitizers anywhere. And even the salespeople were not wearing masks and they were not checking the people who were entering the mall, right? That they should be wearing the masks, right? So this way, so you can address it to the higher authority, to the manager, to the senior person who is there responsible to see that everything should function smoothly, okay? Right? So it could be, you've been traveling regularly by Shatabdi, right? And what have you noticed about the quality of the food or maybe the cleanliness? You want to complain about it to a higher authority, okay? Right? So you complain about that. What can we complain about? You've been traveling in a train and the things that you have noticed. What could be? Once again, it could be cleanliness. It could be about the quality of the food. Right? Clear? Yes? Okay. So all these things here, these are the various letter of complaints that you will be discussing or that we will be discussing throughout this term. Now, when we write a letter of complaint, please hear what should be the tone of writing the letter. Is it a personal complaint? No. Of course, it is not a personal letter. It is not an informal letter. And even informal letters, we are not rude and we don't get so aggressive also. So whenever we write a letter of complaint, we have to be polite. You might be feeling very angry inside. Okay. Oh my God, look what they've done to my order. Look what they've done to my, the function here. You are there, right, with anger, but you have to control yourself. And how is your letter going to be? Your letter is going to be very polite, okay? But it is going to be assertive. You are going to convey your problem very, very clearly, right? So in very clear words, right? Do talk about your problem, right? So that I regret to inform you, right? I would like to bring to your notice. I was deeply hurt, you can say, right? Okay. And this kind of behavior was not expected. So all these lines here, they will show your what? It will show your manner of complaining. So you will talk about that see here. These are the things that I had to bear. These are the things that I had to undergo, right? So when we are talking about a letter of complaint, yes, definitely we are going to give our suggestions. How can we stop giving suggestions if we are writing a letter? So we are going to give our suggestions also. If the order has been wrongly delivered, right? So you had ordered, say, 15 medium size t-shirts and you got 20 large size t-shirts. What are you going to do? You had ordered the color white and you got like maybe a gray color. So you are going to request them to replace it. Yes, naturally. Yeah, so you are going to request them to replace the order. Okay, right. Then, of course, here, if it is about the delay, once again here, when we are talking about business letters, when it is about a delay, we might give them an opportunity to improve themselves. Please remember this. Don't say that, no, I did not expect this, and I will see you in court, and I will cancel my orders. I'm never doing business with you. No, don't get so aggressive. No need to get so aggressive, okay? So what are we going to do here? We have to maintain that firm, assertive tone, okay? Right? That, yes, sir, it's a delay in the order, and you say that, yes, sir, my business is suffering a lot, and I had to, you know, fulfill an order, or you can say a supply for a function. It was required on time, and yes, so because of your delay, it has put me in a very difficult situation, right? And give them a reminder that yes, so you can say that this is maybe the last reminder, or you can say a reminder for you to send the goods at the earliest possible date, so that like more inconvenience is not caused to the customers. Okay, right? So here, and your suggestions here, if you go to a shopping mall and the sales people are not polite, they're not following the COVID protocol. So naturally, yes, it is once again a request you can make, a suggestion you can give, that we should not get so casual during this time of the pandemic. And right, it is always necessary that we maintain or we follow these protocols. Okay, right? So you want to complain about any services here. You hosted a function, you're not happy. What suggestions are you going to give? That proper attention must be given to all aspects, right? So the quality of food, it should be fresh, so that, you know, like, yes, the guests are happy. Because that is what, you know, like we really look forward to in a function here. Of course, the decoration and the cleanliness, all these are little things that need to be taken into account. Okay, right. So do you remember the format of the letter? All of you, come on, write down the format. Let me see it. Let's see. Let's see the format. So what is the format here? Have you noted down these points? Did you note down? Yes? Okay. So for a letter of complaint, what are the things you need to remember? Yes? Can anybody tell me? Do you remember? What do we write? The sender's address. Yes, we write the date. We write the receiver's address. I write a suitable, appropriate salutation. Yes, I write the salutation, right? So, dear, madam, sir, whatever is there required accordingly. I give my subject. And where I have told you again and again, the subject should be brief and relevant enough that the person who is there reading the subject, that is why, because formal letters, you know, sometimes we see the officials, they get so much of correspondence. So yeah, maybe sorting it out and they just quickly look at the problem, and that is highlighted in the subject. So what is the topic or what is the issue that we are discussing? Okay. So subject would be to complain about, delay, okay, or about quality of service, or yes, behavior of salesman, right? Is this visible? Yes. So anything here, that is whatever we are writing the letter about, that is our letter of complaint, that becomes the subject. Okay, so to complain about, fine, right? All these things you have to keep in mind. The subject, keep it relevant. Subject comes after the salutation. You have your subject in the salutation, isn't it? Yes, I think so. It is that way, right? But otherwise, it does not matter much, right? So yeah, your subject comes over here, then comes your salutation, right? Yes. And generally, of course, you write it either way also does not make much of a difference here. Fine. What are we going to talk about in our letter of complaint? What are we going to discuss here? Yes. First is we will talk about the purpose. Naturally, for all the points that we discuss, it is what? A paragraph, you can make a separate one. So we write the purpose of the letter. Yeah. And of course, here it is as a reminder of the, you know, order which is there. Or of course, we talk about the quality, right? Whenever we start off with a letter of complaint, if it is a business letter, if it is a business letter, you can give a reference to your order or letter which you have written earlier. Okay, that this is in reference to my letter regarding my order for sports good, right? You can give a date, you can give a reference of that. Okay, right? And then things would be much clearer and much better. Next is, after I've given them, what is this? What is my purpose here? Talk about the complaint. How are we going to give the complaint? We have to be very, very polite, but yes, assertive. Okay, tone we're going to write. And I am going to give my suggestion. Although you might be feeling very angry, but you have to keep on giving them a reminder. Then, of course, we wind up the letter with yours truly. Okay, right? Fine. And give your proper name. If your designation here in that agency, in that organization, right? Or the manner of writing it. Is this clear? Is this clear? I'll be sending a few letters of complaint for you all to write, and we'll see how it is done again, right? So just remember here. Now I have discussed the value points also. I have given the examples also. So we have to discuss letters of complaint for business purposes, for official purposes, and letter of complaint to editor, right? And please remember, see, when I have read your letters to the editor, which you have been doing, let us change the language a little bit, the language that we write, okay? Yes, that although our locality is a posh locality, but the problem of the potholes is a big issue, right? So I think so, from time immemorial, I've been reading these lines. It's time for you also to change that, okay? Right? So what here with the passage of time, and with carelessness, whether it is the carelessness of the authorities or of the people, whatever is there, so problems are going to happen. And considering so much of traffic on the road and all that, so yes, and you know, the monsoons, so the potholes, it's definitely always going to be a major issue. So please here, make sure that you just bring about a slight change in the manner of writing, especially when you write your letter to editor. I hope you will paste this in your newspaper. Okay, fine, you give space for it, you will publish it, you will print it. Okay, why? I'm discussing about letter to the editor. Do you remember the letter to the editor that you have done? Right? You remember? Yes. And of course, there was a standard procedure and the same lines that you wrote again and again. Now it's the time for you to change. Now it is the time for you to change that skill. Okay, any doubts, any questions regarding letter of complaint? Any doubts? I'll be sharing an example with you all, so you will get an idea how it is written. Okay, then of course, I will be giving you more questions to practice. Hope you are completing your work in your notebook also. I have shared with you the textual questions, right? Yes, I have given you data interpretation paragraphs also. Give me a yes or no, please. Have you done it? Yeah. Okay. So, right. Fine. Good. That's good. That's very nice.